messaging with what Tony's saying, I agree with him. My opinion is it's not going to be enough for Rochester's starters to do what they've always done in the last seven games.
Yeah.
You know, Holland's averaging 17. She's scored as many as 25. Malco's averaging 15. She's had games of 25 and 27. I don't think that's going to be enough. To me, the key is going to be the sixth or seventh person off the bench. If they can come in and contribute, whether it be 10, 15 points, excellent. Or whether they can come in and contribute in the way of rebounding or getting Harding or Schultz or Zahner into foul trouble, that's how the Lady Zebras can counter what the Lady Cavaliers bring to the floor.
Malco and Harding to jump center, and ball's up and controlled by the Lady Cavaliers. Schultz quickly, her pass is picked off by Stasiak. Keaton runs it for the Lady Zebras right through the center circle. Rochester going to our left. Stasiak kicks it out to Holland. Now right side to Malco. Malco drives in the paint, kicks it out to Holland left wing. X holds in the corner to Malco. Becky, a couple of dribbles to the wing, feeds it down low to Bailey Abbott, outside to Larkin. Larkin coming off a 17-point performance on Saturday night at Winnemac, backs it out to the volleyball line and resets for Rochester. Now works at right wing. Lob pass down low to Stasiak. Keaton travels, no call, gets it to Malco. Her layup is good.
That was Abbott.
Bailey Abbott picks up the pass from Stasiak and puts it in for two.
Great job by Stasiak and Abbott working together down low, and Abbott with that dangerous left hand.
Yeah. Zahner down low, goes a little right around Abbott. Her shot good. A lot of contact, no foul. Knocks her to the floor, gets up, we're tied at two. That was a wide open look for Donna Zahner.
Malco trying to come down and help out with the defense, but just not quick enough.
And then Malco's pass is picked off by Donna Zahner, and we're going the other way. We're tied at 2 minute gone in the first quarter. Culver with the basketball going to our right.
And Llewellyn Cavaliers all up north of the free throw line.
Yep.
Nobody down low on the blocks.
2-3 zone by the Lady Zebras. Zahner behind the arc, top of the key to Llewellyn, drives it left. Now to Howard. Marissa Howard holds, looks back to Coach Hurlmeyer, gets direction, now gives to Llewellyn. Now she's in the center circle for the Lady Cavaliers, dribbling to her right. We're tied at two. 6:35 to play first quarter. Llewellyn bounce pass to Schultz. Outside to Howard, stands all alone. Passes up a three, couple of dribbles on the wing, gives him the corner to Llewellyn. Llewellyn down low to Harding. Nice job by Bailey Abbott. Gives to Harding on the left elbow, out to Zahner. Zahner just inside the three-point line. Jumper's too hard. No good. And it's going out of bounds, and Schultz can't save him from going out, and it'll stay with Rochester going to our left.
Well, anytime. I know that Zahner can hit that shot from out there, but I'm thinking anytime the Rochester Lady Zebras can force her outside
Absolutely.
To the arc, it's in their favor.
Absolutely. Holland, right side, drives it left, goes to the baseline, outside to Malco. She drives in the paint against Schultz. Down low to Bailey Abbott. Ball loose, picked up by Schultz and the Lady Cav.
That was not a good pass by Malco. There was no advantage to be gained there. They were standing next to each other.
Howard on the right wing, gives to Zahner, left elbow, outside to Llewellyn. Long three for the Cavs. Short, good block out by Holland, gives to Larkin. Allie Larkin, right side of the floor against Llewellyn. Hesitates, now goes to the basket. Pull-up jumper on the baseline is good, and Rochester's up 4-2.
Great job by Larkin. She drove around Llewellyn, who was trying to pick up the charge, and just hit that little four-foot jumper on the baseline.
Zahner to Llewellyn. Llewellyn jump pass down, little Hardy. Her layup is good, and we're tied at four. Culver breaks the press easily.
They don't waste any time getting down the floor, and they find them open lanes.
Larkin bounce pass ahead to Malco. Malco against a double team. Against to Larkin, now leads ahead to Holland. Holland misses Bailey Abbott all alone on the block, pulls it back outside to Larkin. Larkin at the elbow, drives, stops, rises up, shot off the corner of the backboard, no good. Rebound fall for Schultz, comes out of there with it, now to Zahner.
That was a good shot by Larkin. She just missed the angle on the backboard.
Llewellyn now will bring it up the court. She'll cross through right through the center circle against Rochester's 1-2 zone. Is that right? 2-1-2 zone, that is. Schultz right side, now inside the three-point line, jump pass to Hardy, pass tipped away, ball still loose, there's a fight for it, Rochester and Culver are going to be tied up, and the Lady Zebras are going to get it back on the Culver turnover, with 4:45 to play in the first quarter, we're tied at four, boy, they're letting them bang already.
Yeah, they are, and the Lady Zebras doing a good job of trying to front and get somebody behind both Harding and Zahner when they're down low.
Holland gets the pass in from Larkin, gets it back to Larkin, now to Stasiak, quickly to Malco. Rochester breaks the press. Malco, middle of the floor, goes all the way to the glass. Pass down low is tipped away by Schultz. Good job. And then we're going to have a tie-up between Stasiak and Howard.
Well,
and Culver going to get it back.
Back to the Lady Cavaliers. I'll tell you what, boy, physically the Lady Cavaliers, I think they all of them, their arms are about 3 or 4 inches longer than anybody else on the Lady Zebras.
They are long. I agree.
You know, when they put that full-court press up there, it's not so much the size as it is the length of their arms. They just cover a lot of ground.
So Culver breaks the press. Llewellyn has it on the right wing against Rochester's 2-3 zone. Now it's cross court to Howard. Howard high on the left side for the Culver Lady Cavaliers. And then Holland picks her pocket. X, right-handed layup is no good. Rebound to Stasiak, puts it up. She's fouling the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
So the foul's going to be on Howard, her first, team first.
You know, we haven't mentioned this yet in our broadcast this year. Congratulations to Alexa Holland. She's verbally committed to Marshall to play, or I'm sorry, to Ohio to play softball. She and I were just talking a little bit during the JV game, and she is super excited to be playing softball in the MAC.
That's great. Yeah, congratulations to her.
You know, earlier in the year, Becky Malco committed to Indiana State to play softball as well. So the free throw by Stasiak's good. Rochester up by one. One more coming for the junior.
Both of those girls juniors, so they got another season of softball, two more seasons of softball left.
Stasiak's second one is good again. That's right. 6-4. Rochester up by two with 4:10 to play in the first quarter. Llewellyn over the top of the defense to Howard. Now quickly to Hardy. Hardy back to Llewellyn, top of the key. Swings right side to Schultz. Behind the arc, three on the right baseline for Culver. He is off the mark, no good. And the rebound about Malco. Rochester runs to my left. Malco around the defense, in the paint. Kicks it outside to Larkin. Three straight away for the Lady Zebras. It's good!
Allie Larkin, great job picking up where she left off from Saturday.
9-4 Rochester. 3:40 to play in the first quarter. Llewellyn brings it up the floor. Llewellyn picks up a dribble over the top of the defense to Howard. Howard back to Llewellyn, middle of the floor. Works the right wing, pulls it back outside, and resets for Culver. Back to Schultz, right side. Schultz, top of the key to Llewellyn. Llewellyn drives it left, one dribble to Howard. Howard, Rochester doing a great job at Hardy and Zahner. Back to Llewellyn, in the paint, kicks it out to Schultz. Schultz drives, travels.
We're going to have a foul on
Stasiak. We're going to have a foul, wow. I think she got away with the travel. Llewellyn knows, thinks it's a travel too, because she's walking to the other
away.
End. Keaton Stasiak's going to pick up a foul. And you can tell Coach Stasiak was a little concerned with their height because Kennedy only played two quarters of the JV.
Yeah.
Llewellyn in the corner for three for the Lady Cavs. Nope. Air ball. And Stasiak couldn't keep it from going out of bounds. And we'll stay with Culver.
Great job by Stasiak getting blocked out, blocking out on that weak side. She just couldn't get a handle on the basketball.
Schultz will trigger it in. Baseline left. Schultz over the top of the defense to Llewellyn.
Missed Harding wide
yep.
open.
Llewellyn in the paint. Outside to Zahner. Feet on the line. Long jumpers. No good. And the weak side rebound to Schultz. She's found the putback. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Larkin going to pick up the foul. Her first.
Tatum Schultz will go to the line to shoot two. Talked to Donna Zahner's dad a little bit ago, and he's saying that she's got four or five schools, NAIA type of schools, looking at her. Congratulations.
Great. Yeah, great.
So Schultz at the line for two. First on the way for Tatum is good. Nothing but the bottom of the net. She'll have one more. And Coach Stasiak will bring in the freshman Morgan Ruff, and she'll replace Keaton Stasiak. 3:09 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 9-5, and one more free throw coming for Schultz. Tatum eyes it, flies it, no good. And the rebound to Hardy, her putback is no good. The rebound back up, no good, but a foul coming on Rochester. And that's going to send Michaela Hardy to the line to shoot two.
And that's someplace where the Lady Zebras are going to have to do a much better job of blocking out and making a lane in there, because Harding and Schultz and Zahner will be able to just, you know,
yeah.
You can't allow them to have their freedom
make
on the board.
You're right. So Hardy has two for the Lady Cavs. Eyes the first one, lets it fly. It's on the way and no good. Bailey Abbott, by the way, just picked up her first personal with 3:06 to play in the first quarter. Rochester by four. One more free throw coming for the senior, Michaela Hardy. Hardy, couple of dribbles. Holds the ball in the left hand. Now ready to play. And we're going to have a lane violation on Zahner, and it's going to go to Rochester. Turnover?
I don't know. She shot the free throw and missed it anyway. So
well,
yeah.
Full court press. Barking with the basketball, now to X, cross court to Holland, or make that to Malco, crosses the timeline, runs around to Hardy, picks her way through the defense, down low to Bailey Abbott, her layup is good, and the foul!
Nice job by Bailey Abbott, making the shot in traffic with contact.
I thought she traveled too. Bailey Abbott at the line to shoot one. Rochester up by six with 2:55 to play in the first quarter.
Schultz picking up that foul for the Lady Cavs.
Bailey ready. The lefty fires the first one. It's good as she completes the three-point play. She struggled a little bit at the line this year. Rochester by seven, a 2:50 to play in the first quarter. Rochester will pick him up the timeline. Llewellyn to Howard, back to Llewellyn, crosses to the center circle over the top of the defense to Schultz to Zahner. Zahner the lane, jumper's good. Easy.
And that's one of those where Ruff's just going to have to be quicker.
Yeah.
And get in front.
Ruff gives up about 5 inches.
Yep. So she's going to have she's going to have to move her feet and get in position.
1-2-2 zone. Schultz loses the handle. Fight for it on the baseline. She gets it back. Bangs it off the hands of Hardy. Out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by
Ruff.
And it'll go back to Culver. Ruff and Schultz battling down there. She banged it off the hands of Hardy, who deflected it off the hands of Ruff, and is going to go back to the Culver on the Rochester turnover.
Lady Zebras trying to press three-quarter court, and the Lady Cavaliers just too quick and too long.
Zahner looks to go over the top to Hardy. Can't get good defense by Ruff. Out to Schultz now, top of the key. Swings back to Llewellyn, middle of the floor. Llewellyn, left wing, pulls it back at the volleyball line now and resets for Culver. Now gives off to Schultz. Under two to play in the first quarter. Rochester by five. Now Schultz pulls it back. So it looks at Coach Hurlmeyer, gets direction, and pulls it out. And now Rochester will meet Schultz at the timeline. Becky Malko inside of Schultz's jersey gets it to Hardy, way outside left. Hardy against Ruff. Now to Zahner. Zahner, Rochester man-to-man defense. Back to Schultz. Schultz takes Malko to the right baseline. Down low to Hardy. Layup on the way is good.
And Hardy's who they're trying to get it to. That's where the mismatch is. And they did a good job that time of working the ball around and bringing Hardy in from the opposite side for the open layup.
12-9. Holland all alone in the left corner. Three is good.
And that, those kind of shots are what's going to help Rochester a lot in this ball game, as long as Larkin and Malko and Holland can continue to knock down the threes.
15-9 Rochester, a minute to play in the first quarter. Howard and the baseline to Zahner. Zahner, lob pass to Hardy, layup is good.
Again, wide open Hardy.
Yeah, Coach Stasiak says, let's run.
Hardy's got six in this quarter.
Six of the 11. Malko pulls it out. 55 seconds to play, first quarter. Holland around the defense to Malko. Becky holds against the double team. One dribble, cross court. To Holland. Holland across the timeline again. Now to Holland. Malko top of the key left. 40 seconds to play. First quarter, Rochester by four. Holland. Bounce pass back to Malko. Stands right in front of the scorer's table with 32.
Zahner looking her right in the eyes.
That's a 29.
That's a formidable opponent to have to try and throw that ball across or around to the other side.
That wraparound pass to Larkin with 19. Now to Ruff. Out to Malko with 17, and she holds. Becky holds with 15. Becky holds at the volleyball line with 12. Becky holds at the volleyball line with 10.
Hardy looking to guard Holland in the corner.
Malko down low to Abbott. Abbott, jumper is no good. Around the rim with two. Rebound to Hardy with one, and that'll do it for the first quarter. After one, Rochester leads 15-11. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save. First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966.
Going to the second quarter here at Rochester High School, the Lady Zebras will start the second period of the basketball, going to our left and leading 15-11.
Abbott and Larkin with five apiece for the Lady Zebras in that first quarter. Michaela Hardy with six for the Lady Cavaliers in that first quarter. Lady Zebras desperately going to have to find an answer for Michaela Hardy.
Well, I think they got to go back to that 2-3 zone.
Yeah, you've got to throttle up that middle.
Stasiak will come back into the game, and Bailey Abbott will start this quarter on the bench.
And the zone is what the Lady Cavaliers are playing.
Yep. Holland to Larkin. Larkin works to the right wing, pulls it out, and resets for Rochester at the volleyball line. Now in the corner to X, fakes the three, drives it back to Larkin. She'll fire a three from the right wing. Good again!
Larkin hits her second three of the ball game.
18-11, Rochester by seven, with 7.5 to play in the first half.
1-3-1 zone for the Lady Zebras.
Schultz Pulls it out. Gives it to Llewellyn at the timeline. Now on the left side is Llewellyn. Over the top of the defense to Stallier, who's back in the game. To Hardy. Back to Schultz. Feeds down low to Zahner. Zahner against a double team. Foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
It's all right. Morgan Ruff coming in from the opposite side to apply pressure. She's going to pick up the foul and send Zahner to the free throw line.
I enjoy watching Donna Zahner play. I saw her a little bit this year at Fort Wayne in the D, whatever.
Yeah, she's always got herself in the right place at the right time.
D1 camp is what I'm going to get at.
And uses her body really, really well to screen off the defender. Created an opening for herself down low.
Donna Zahner with one more. Looking to cut this lead to five. Second on the way is no good. And the rebound to Stasiak. Keaton clears and gives to Holland. Rochester by six. 7-10 to play in the first half. Holland middle of the floor, right side to Larkin. Now back to Holland left wing. Fakes left, goes right. Out to Larkin, wide open three, right wing. No good, too hard. And rebound to Malco.
Great job by Malco. Those are the keys. I think one of the keys to this ball game is the Zebras getting second opportunities with the rebounding.
Holland for three, top of the key is short. And Zahner with the board. Zahner gives to Llewellyn. Rochester by six. Culver runs to our right. Llewellyn over the top of the defense to Schultz. Schultz down low to Hardy. Hardy over the double team. It's good.
Number 32.
18-14. Rochester. Bailey Abbott will come back into the game after the next dead ball. Larkin right side to Holland. High on the right side. X top to Malco. Becky one dribble back to Holland right wing. Back to Malco. Fakes the pass inside out to Ruff. Morgan drives it right. Gives to Larkin outside right. Now to Malco. Becky in the lane. Wraparound pass to Stasiak. Her jumper is blocked out of bounds by Culver. And it's going to stay with Rochester baseline left as Abbott comes back into the game.
Keith Stasiak did a great job as Malco drove down the right side of the lane. Stasiak sealed off her defender behind her, creating an opening for her to get that cross lane pass.
Larkin in the corner to Holland. X against Llewellyn in man-to-man defense. Drives it right in the paint. Fakes the pass. Throws up a shot. It's good. After one quarter, West Central leads Winamac 20-6.
Wow.
Rochester in a 2-3 zone. We knew that they were going to go back to that. They got to stop Hardy with that wide open look.
You're right.
Llewellyn runs the point, stands in the center circle.
Abbott in the middle of the zone for the Lady Zebras.
Sallier around the defense. Loses the handle. Alexa Holland has it. X. Left-handed layup off the window. Good. Rochester up by eight at 5:30 to play in the first half.
That's just the sixth turnover by the Lady Cavaliers, but the last three have resulted in buckets for the Lady Zebras.
Llewellyn to Schultz, high on the left side. Schultz over the top of the defense to Llewellyn. Fakes a passes up a three. Now to Sallier, left side to Schultz. Schultz drives it left, cut off by the defense. Over the top to Llewellyn at the timeline. X chases her out there. And then that pass is tipped away and stolen. Actually off the foot of Rochester. Becky Malco saves from going out of bounds. Down the middle of the floor. Stop. Down low to Abbott. Jumper over Zahner. Nope. Hardy with a rebound for Culver. 22-14 Rochester. Under five to play in the first half. Zahner to Llewellyn. Llewellyn crossover dribbles. Goes to the free throw line. Jump passes to Schultz. Down low to Hardy. And Hardy's going to be fouled by Bailey Abbott. And that'll be two on Abbott. And I'm guessing Coach Stasiak will probably look at...
He's going to have to go. Yeah, well, I was even thinking Kennedy. Bring some size, and he is going to go with Garrison.
Back into the game is Howard for Culver. Alexa Garrison will come in for Bailey Abbott, who will set with two fouls. 4:47 to play, first half, Rochester by eight. Culver basketball baseline left. Schultz looks to trigger it in. Tatum studies. No look pass into Llewellyn. Stands behind the arc in the left wing. Now dribbles to the top of the key. Lob pass to Schultz. She'll fire a three from the right corner. It's off the mark. No good. Rebound to Hardy. She loses the handle. She gets it back. She puts it up, and it's good.
Number 30.
So active.
Hardy now with 10.
Yeah.
10
Kayla Hardy. So active. Somebody's going to have to put a butt in her. Larkin. Her pass is a tough pass to handle. Becky Malco gets it back.
Well, there
left side to Larkin.
Aren't many openings in that 2-3 zone.
Yeah,
by
you're right.
Cavaliers. Malco got lucky driving in there, I think, before and found an opening, and there aren't too many.
Larkin left side. She'll fire a three. That's going to be off the mark. No good. Rebound fought for, and Schultz comes out of there with it, and they're going to say, actually, last touch by Tatum out of bounds. It will stay with Rochester baseline left. With 4:06 to play in the first half, Rochester up 22-16. Holland will look to trigger it in baseline left. X. Bounce pass into Larkin. Larkin cross court to Holland in the corner. Alexa Holland against Llewellyn. Pulls it out to Malco. She drives it in the paint. Stops, and she's on the way there, and she's going to be fouled by Zahner, I believe. And it'll be out of bounds to Rochester with 3:58 to play in the first half.
That is against Zahner. They're her first team third. Yeah, the Lady Zebras can't get too comfortable with that three-point shot.
Yeah.
They've had some success with some of them falling. But
what else is the answer?
You're right. Well, you have to keep attacking that zone. You got to try and get in the middle.
Zahner, make that Garrison puts it in after a nice inbound pass from Holland. And Garrison puts it in for two, and Rochester back up by eight. 3:45 to play. Hardy, turnaround jumper in the paint, off the back of the rim, no good. Zahner with the rebound, and we're going to have a foul coming on Stasiak. And Keaton is still down. Keaton is still down. She's going to pick up foul number two.
That's her second.
Keaton's still down. Keaton's still down on the floor. Larkin will. Larkin.
Yeah, she's limping really bad on that knee. So,
Keaton just said that she was her leg was stomped on while she was on the floor. So she comes out, and Christina Hughes is looking at her now, right now. So Bailey and both Keaton are out. Rochester by eight at 24-16. Culver basketball baseline right. Lob pass to Hardy. Her jumper off the window is off the mark. No good. And Larkin to the rebound.
Great rebound by Larkin.
Allie runs down the right left side of the floor. Out here to Holland. Holland, top to Malco. Becky, one dribble back to Holland. Wide open three, left wing. No good. In and out. And Hardy with the rebound. And now we're going to have a travel on Michaela Hardy, and it's going to be out of bounds to Rochester.
Well, the Lady Zebras are really going to have to pick it up on the rebounding with Stasiak out of the ballgame.
Baseline left is Holland. Lobs it in over the defense to Malco. Outside to Ruff. Quickly to Holland in the right corner. Holland back to Malco with 3:58 to make that 3:15 to play in the first half. Rochester by eight. Larkin for three. Left side short. Bounces around the rim. Ball fought for. Schultz comes out of there with it. Down to Llewellyn. Left side of the floor. Llewellyn. Crossover dribble. Goes to the baseline. And she's going to be tied up with Ruff. And it's going to stay with Culver. Baseline left.
Great job by Morgan Ruff. She just, when Llewellyn picked her dribble up, Ruff just grabbed the hold of the basketball and wrestled it away from her.
Quick hands.
Yep.
Schultz will look to trigger it in, baseline left.
Looking hard as she's got the mismatch with Ruff guarding her right now.
Tatum slaps the basketball, sends things in motion. Gets it into Hardy behind the three-point line, now top to Llewellyn. Llewellyn back to Schultz, behind the arc by herself. Good defense, down low to Hardy. Hardy kicks it out to Zahner for three. Right wing for the Lady Cavs. Off the mark, no good. And the ball being tipped around. Ruff comes out of there with it. Now Tatum Schultz is going to be whistled for the reach-in, and it's going to be out of bounds to Rochester with 2:50 to play in the first half.
That'll be Schultz's second.
Well, they can't do without her. They can't do without any of them.
No, you're right. They don't go very deep. What'd you say, six maybe?
Yeah, right. Yeah. So the fourth team foul on Culver. Rochester has 16 fouls, and Coach Hurlmeyer will have to go back to the bench, and Saylor will come back in. Make that Sailor will come back in for Culver at the next dead ball. 2:40 to play, first half, Rochester by eight. Ruff fakes it, drives it right. Jump pass over to Holland.
She's got to be careful that she doesn't pick up a charge from Llewellyn.
Bounce pass to Malco. Right wing, sends in the left corner to Holland. Jump pass to Larkin. 2:25 to play, first half, Rochester by eight. Now back to Holland, left wing. X drives it left against Howard. Now pulls it back outside behind the arc. She'll step back three on the way. Good! Rochester by 11 at 27-16.
Holland just gets her 10th point of the ballgame.
Kurt Hurlmeyer said, man, we were playing good defense. She just stepped back and drained it right in her face. Schultz, lob pass to Llewellyn in the left corner. Down low to Zahner. Zahner against the double team, puts it up, no good. Rebound fall for Hardy comes out of there with it. Her put back, no good. She puts it back again, it's good.
Lady Zebras got to be ready for that rebound. Garrison had position. She just wasn't ready for the rebound when it come off the rim.
Minute 45 to play, first half. Rochester by nine. Malco, cross-court pass to Ruff. Three on the way from the baseline is good. Make that a two. Rochester back up by 11. 90 seconds to play, first quarter, first half. Hardy down low, foul on the shot. Shot's no good. Allie Larkin's picked up foul number two.
Two, yep.
And that's going to send Michaela Hardy back to the line to shoot two for the Lady Cavs with 90 seconds to play in the first quarter with Rochester up by 11.
Hardy's got 6 points in the ballgame. She's 0 for 2 from the line.
The Athletic 44. Free throw by Hardy is no good. Kennedy Musselman in the game for the first time.
That might be the answer. Fowler. She has yet to make a free throw.
Yeah, Hackershack.
Well,
Dyer back in and Schultz is out now.
With Kennedy in the ballgame, you know, she doesn't have to come into this game and score 20 points,
yeah,
although that would be nice.
Oh,
what
boy.
She really needs to do is just put a body on Hardy.
Free throws, Hardy is good this time. It's 29-19, 90 seconds to play, first half. Rochester the basketball. Coach Stasiak will look to pull it out and run some clock. 1-2-2 zone by Culver. Becky holds right in front of the scores table. Clock rolls with a minute 15 to play in the first half. Becky still holds. Still holds. No pressure. Culver still in that zone. We're down to a minute 10 to play in the first half. Rochester by 10.
Just
Becky Malco just holding.
Just don't get complacent when it comes time to pass out across court.
Yeah.
Zahner is so quick and so long. Lazy pass, she'll have it.
Now under a minute to play. Becky still holds. Now they come out of that zone defense and go to a man-to-man. Becky Malco will be matched up with Zahner. Under 50 seconds to play, first half. Becky still holds. Donna Zahner giving her a good 10 feet.
And, well, Zahner guarding Malco most of this ball game. That's the reason Becky doesn't have any points yet in this game. That's a tough matchup for her to have to deal with.
35 seconds. Becky still holds. Down to 30 seconds. Becky still holds. Rochester up by 10. Becky now being applied the pressure. Runs around Zahner in the paint. Jump pass, or actually the shot in the lane is good. 20 seconds. Howard over the top to Llewellyn with 18. Llewellyn goes to the baseline. Down low to Hardy. Hardy against Musselman. We're going to have a tie-up. Rochester going to get it back with 13.8.
Great job. Like I said, coming off the bench, you don't have to score a lot of points. You just got to make it more difficult for Hardy.
Larkin comes in, and Garrison will come out. 13.8 to play in the first half. Bailey Abbott will come back in, and Kennedy will come out. And Kennedy will come out. 13.8 to play in the first half. Rochester by 12. They've got the final shot of the half coming. Malco, a little jog up the court. Crosses through the center circle with 8. Works to the right side with 7. In the paint. Riser over Zahner. No good with 4. Zahner picks it up with 2. Zahner not going to get a shot off at halftime. After the first half, Rochester leads 31-19. You're listening to Ladies Eagle Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Buying your first home? Let the experts at First Federal Savings Bank help you through the process. At First Federal, all of their mortgage loans are serviced locally, with payment options that are convenient for you. Their staff will work with you, answering your questions and providing professional service. First Federal will even pay standard closing costs for qualifying first-time homebuyers. Just another way First Federal takes care of you, your local mortgage lender. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
Going to the third quarter, the Lady Cavaliers will start the second half of the basketball going to our left. Rochester on the floor to start the second half. Their starters, including Keaton Stasiak. That's a good sign.
Yeah, it is. Good to see her come back in. A little get in that leg, but
yeah, a little left there,
not too bad.
Rochester's going to be in a zone defense, a 2-3 zone, 2-1-2 zone, somewhere like that.
Yep, Abbott sliding ball side to double team on the low post.
Zahner is going to be tied up or
traveled.
Either way, Rochester's going to get it back. That's what happens when you're that big and bring it down to your waist.
Yeah. Yeah.
So Rochester going to get it back up by 12 with 7:46 to play in the third.
Lady Cavaliers going to a man-to-man.
Malco to Bailey Abbott. Loses the handle. Picks it up at the volleyball line. Bounce pass to Malco here on the near side. You're right. Culver in a man-to-man defense. Drives it left as Malco. Cut off by the defense, out to Holland. Holland looks at the three, fakes it, drives it outside to Larkin. Larkin in the right corner, drives the baseline, pull up 10-footer right side. It's good!
Great shot by Larkin. She had the three-point shot. She just couldn't get a handle on the path. she made the best of it by driving the baseline and getting a little jumper.
And Salyer will come back into the next opportunity here. We're not even a minute gone in the third quarter. Llewellyn, three on the way. Good for Culver.
Wow, she'd been quiet that entire first half. I'm guessing something got said about she needed to find her shot.
33-22, Rochester by 11 with 7 minutes to play, third quarter. Malco against Schultz, takes it right in the lane, kicks it out to Larkin. Three, right wing for Rochester. Short, and Howard to the rebound. Howard then gives it off to Zahner, now to Llewellyn. Culver runs to our left, Llewellyn high on the right side for the Lady Cavs. Now directs traffic top of the key to Howard, left side to Schultz. Tatum, a couple of dribbles at the elbow to Howard. Howard's jumper on the way is off the window and good. And now the lead is down to 9 for Rochester. Yep. 6.5 to play in the third.
Coming out of the halftime, looks like Cavaliers are using Zahner and Hardy as
the decoys.
As decoys to get the rest of them into the game.
Malco 3, top of the keys, off the back of the iron, no good. Hardy rips the board and gives to Llewellyn. Culver runs up, down by 9.
Lady Zevers can't get too comfortable with that 3-point shot.
Schultz outside to Llewellyn, over her head, out of bounds, and it'll go back to Rochester. So Salyer back into the game, and Howard will come in. 6-10 to play in the third, Rochester by 9 at 33-24. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Rochester, the ball going to our right. Becky Malco runs the point, walks it through the center circle. Culver awaiting them in the man-to-man defense. Malco top of the key, drives left, crossover dribble. Loses the handle, but right into the hands of X, thankfully.
Yeah, no kidding.
Holland, Malco top of the key, drives it right. Leaner on the way, and we're going to have a foul before the shot. Is that going to be on Schultz? If so, that'll be 3 on Tatum.
And that is her third.
Number 30,
that's going to be hamper the Lady Cavaliers a little bit.
Yeah, Coach Hurlmeyer not even thinking about going to the bench. Holland looks to get it in. X over the top of the key to Larkin. Larkin grabs it, picks it up, now drives. Larkin through the center circle, top of the key, stops, kicks it outside to Malco. Becky against Schultz in the lane. Jumper on the way in the paint is no good. Rebound to Tatum Schultz, and Becky Malco comes over the back and commits a foul. And you can see right there was 3 fouls. Tatum Schultz just took herself out of the play defensively, and Malco had a wide open look.
Yeah, she just too hard off the back of the rim, and you could tell when she missed it right away she was going to get the foul because she was intent on getting that rebound, but she didn't get herself in position to do so.
So noted, she knows next time she goes in the lane with Schultz guarding her, the same thing's going to happen.
Yep.
Zahner around Abbott. Bounce pass to Salyer. Salyer, a couple of dribbles at the elbow, out to Zahner. Top the key to Llewellyn. 5:20 to play, third quarter. Rochester by 9. Down low to Hardy. Hardy over Stasiak, good.
And still Hardy. Nobody with an answer for her.
Yep. 33-26. Rochester by 7. It's 5:05 to play in the third quarter. Malco in the paint. Cut off by the defense. Now to Bailey Abbott. Left elbow outside to Holland. X. Fakes it, drives it, in the paint. Wraparound shot off the glass, well good. Rebound to Culver's Tatum Schultz, who gives to Llewellyn.
Holland did a great job of getting to the backboard and getting the ball up on the rim. She just put too much English on it, couldn't get it to fall through.
So Culver has it going to our left. Schultz in the center circle, out to Llewellyn, high on the right side. Llewellyn against the double team, dribbles around that, jump pass down low to Salyer. Salyer loses the handle, ball kicked around, picked up by Llewellyn and Culver. Outside now to Hardy. Hardy holds top of the key. Left side to Zahner with 4.5 to play in the third. Rochester by 7. Now to Llewellyn.
Hardy going to work from the free throw line and slide down. That's where she's been dangerous. Right there it is.
Zahner, wide open 3. Rochester left her. She shoots it. No good. And the rebound by Donna Zahner. And Rochester going to get it back.
And Zahner going to pick up the foul. That'll be her second.
So Zahner has 2. Schultz has 3. And Rochester has the basketball up by 7.
And now they need to attack.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
4:16 to play in the third quarter. Rochester the basketball going to our right. Becky Malco and Larkin kind of chat coming up the floor. Now go to the left side. Malco in the paint, goes to the basket hard. Throws up a shot partially blocked by Culver. Picked up by Schultz. Schultz brings it up the floor to cutting Hardy. Hardy layup, good. 33-28.
Harding with 17.
Zahner outside to Malco. Becky in the paint. Goes all the way to the basket. Throws up a shot over Zahner. Partially blocked by Donna. Picked up by Hardy. Hardy now to Llewellyn. Llewellyn. To Hardy. Hardy's 5-footer. Blocked out of bounds by Malco. Get it out of here!
So the last 2 trips down the floor for the Rochester Lady Zebras, Malco has done exactly what we said they would do. She has attacked Schultz and Hardy. The problem? No score. No foul.
Yeah. Schultz baseline left. Schultz looking to get it in. Looking for Hardy. Has her on the block. Turns it over. Ball loose. Rochester going to get it. Now we're going to have a jump ball between Hardy and Stasiak, and Rochester going to get it back. 3.5 to play, third quarter. Rochester up 33-28. It'll be Rochester basketball going to our right.
Lady Cavaliers have outscored the Lady Zebras in this third quarter 9-2.
Yeah.
The Lady Zebras have owned the third quarter all season this year.
Well, I'll give you my thoughts here in a minute. Malco around the defense to Larkin from the baseline. No good. And the rebound fall for. And Zayner's going to pick up foul number three for tackling Stasiak. Here's what my thought is. And you tell me how far I'm off.
Okay.
Rochester right now intent, it looks like, on getting Culver to pick up a foul instead of running the offense to get a point.
I agree with you. Yeah, I agree with you. That time Larkin had a good shot. She was wide open. She just came up long on the rim. Stasiak, a great job of blocking out Zayner.
Holland lobs it into Malco. Top of the key. Becky in the paint. Cut off by the defense. Out to Larkin. 3:10 to play. Third quarter. Rochester up 33-28. Larkin works to the right side against Schultz. Still behind the arc. Working right side. Now at the elbow. To Malco. Left side. Becky drives. Layup is going to be blocked by Hardy. Hardy will pick it up. And give to Tatum Schultz. Schultz will bring it up the floor for Culver.
The other thing I would add to what you said, David, is that the Lady Cavaliers are in a man-to-man, and the Lady Zebras are having a lot of fits with that, trying to drive into the paint.
Yeah. Zayner to Llewellyn, three, left wing. Off mark too hard. Malco runs down a loose ball rebound and will run. 33-28 Rochester, 2:35 to play in the third. Malco top the key.
When the Lady Cavs were in a zone, when the Lady Cavs were in the zone, the Lady Zebras were able to find those open shots and knock them down.
Salyer going to pick up a foul. And Rochester have it out of bounds baseline right. Holland looks to get it in. Bounce pass into Stasiak. Keaton dribbles to the wing behind the arc right side. And now will drive against Hardy. Crossover dribble, takes it to the glass. Throws up a shot. She's fouled on the shot by Hardy. That's going to send Stasiak to the line to shoot two.
That'll be Hardy's first.
Are you sure you're keeping the book right?
Yep.
Just one, huh?
One foul and 17 points.
Yeah, that's fair. So Stasiak the line to shoot two freebies. First one by the juniors, they're good. You have one more. And now Culver will use a timeout. It will be a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Minutes, 23 seconds to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 34-28. After the Culver timeout, Rochester and Keene Stasiak will be at the line for one.
Yeah, the Lady Zebras with as much as a 12-point lead in this basketball game.
Yep.
Now it's down to six. And I think we should say
it's back up to six.
Yeah, it was what, down to four?
Yeah.
I think the key to that for the Lady Cavaliers has been their man-to-man defense that they came out and started this third quarter with, and the mentality of the Rochester Lady Zebras where they're looking to attack in such a manner as to pick up fouls against the Lady Cavs instead of looking to attack the score.
I would agree with that. Yep. Stasiak with one more. Keaton eyes it, flies it. Second one, no good. And the rebound to Hardy.
And she continues to be the workforce for this Lady Cavaliers basketball team. She's carrying them.
Schultz high on the right side, 2:10 to play, third quarter to Zayner. In the corner to Llewellyn, three over Mackie Malco, is good!
That's her second three of this quarter. And boy, you can't, Lady Zebras could not afford to have her get lit up.
Culver cuts the lead to three, under two to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 34-31. Stasiak at the free throw line, drives to the paint, kicks it out to Larkin. Larkin against Schultz, works right side, gets a pick from Stasiak. Jumper on the way from the elbow is short. Rebound, fall four. Culver and Schultz comes out of there with it. Tatum now gives to Llewellyn. 40 seconds to make that 100 seconds to play in the third quarter. Rochester up by three. Donna Zahner holds at the timeline. Rochester going to let her hold. Right side to Llewellyn. Three for the tie. Partially blocked and short. And the rebound fall four. We're going to have a tie-up, and Culver going to keep possession with a minute 23 to play in the third quarter.
Well, a lot of the energy and fire we saw from the Lady Zebras in that first and second quarter just isn't there in this third quarter.
Well, the shots haven't fallen either.
Well, they haven't been near as open as they were in the first half.
Yeah, I agree. Llewellyn baseline right. A minute 23 to play in the third. Rochester by three. Now Hardy will look to trigger it in. Michaela Hardy. Gives it to Zahner. Cross court to Schultz. Schultz back down to Hardy. Turnaround jumper over Stasiak. No good. And the rebound to Ruff. Morgan gives to Holland. A minute 10 to play. Third quarter. Rochester by three. X has been quiet this quarter. Fakes. Drives. Pulls it back outside.
She's had Llewellyn in her jersey the entire quarter.
To Larkin. Left side. Works against Zahner. Works her to the wing. Under a minute to play in the third quarter. Rochester by three.
Larkin's got the lone field goal for the Lady Eagles this quarter.
A free throw or two as well.
One free throw by Stasiak, one field goal by Larkin. That's it.
Ruff holds, top of the key. Man-to-man defense by Culver. Out to Malco with 42 seconds. Malco drives it left, cut off by the defense. Out to Stasiak with 38. Keaton holds with 35. Now to Larkin with 34. Alley works right side with 32. Now in the paint for Rochester. Kicks it out to Ruff with 28. Morgan Ruff goes to the basket hard. She throws up a shot. It's good!
Great job by Morgan Ruff getting that little spin off the backboard over Hardy and around Schultz.
18 seconds. Salyer loses the basketball to bounds. Rochester going to get it back.
Great job by Larkin again. Right there creating a turnover for the Lady Zebras.
14 seconds to play in the third quarter. Rochester by five. Larkin to Holland. Holland across the timeline with 10. Holland top of the key with 8. Drives it right. Switches direction. Goes left with 7. Holland picks it away through traffic. Out to Malco with 4. Her 3 on the way is no good. Rebound to Schultz. Knocked out of bounds. And Stasiak is going to pick up a foul.
With 2 seconds.
36-31. 2 seconds to play in the third. And Keaton just picked up foul number 3.
Yep. Harding wide open.
Baseball pass shot at the buzzer is no good. After three, Rochester leads 36-31. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here. Oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Going to the fourth and final quarter here at Rochester High School. Lady Zebras leading 36-31. It's been a long, long time since Culver's led. They've been close a couple of times. I think maybe the last time, I'm not sure they've ever led.
I don't think they have.
I think Rochester tied them up at 2-2, then 4-4, then 6-6, and then Rochester kind of went on a little 5-0, 6-0 run.
Yeah.
So Rochester will start with the basketball, going to our right, up by 5.
Well, a couple three-pointers in that quarter by Llewellyn. Definitely a big spark for the Lady Cavaliers, but it's still Michaela Hardy.
Bailey Abbott back in, and Stasiak is out. We have some foul difficulties.
Stasiak with 3, Larkin and Abbott with 2. For the Lady Cavaliers, Schultz and Zahner with 3.
Malco at the free throw line, out to Ruff. Morgan just inside the three-point line, pulls it back outside, now to Larkin. Larkin against Zahner, man-to-man defense, works her to the corner, crossover dribble, takes her down low to the block. Her jumper is on the way, no good. Salyer with the rebound, good-looking shot, she got a great look, just couldn't get it to go.
One and done for the Lady Zebras.
Hardy down low, threads a pass to Howard. It gives to Stout, makes that Llewellyn just inside the three-point line. Her jumper's off the mark, no good. Tatum Schultz gets away with the rebound. The jumper put back by Hardy is no good. And X has it. X runs for Rochester, up by five. Holland on the right wing against Llewellyn, top to Malco. Swings left side to Ruff, now quickly to Larkin. Feeds down low to Bailey Abbott, and Bailey Abbott's going to be fouled by Michaela Hardy.
Hardy picks up her second.
And it'll be, what, the team fifth?
Yep.
Yeah, I would agree with that. End of the third quarter, West Central leads Winamac 49-24. Holland looks to inbound baseline left. Gets it in to Larkin. Larkin over Hardy. No, no way. Llewellyn skies to the board and grabs it.
He's got to use glass.
Yeah.
You're not going to get it over the rim over Hardy.
Over the top of the defense to Schultz. 36-31 Rochester. Minute gone in the fourth quarter. Llewellyn over the top of the defense to Zahner. Now to Schultz. Schultz in the paint. Goes to the basket hard. Layup is on the way. Is no good. Rebound being tipped.
Oh.
Bailey Abbott tips it in. And they're going to give that bucket to Hardy, I'm guessing.
Okay.
36-33. Rochester on top by three. More at Ruff. Drives the basket. Throws up a layup. It's short.
Oh.
Rebound fall for Llewellyn comes out of there with it. Boy, she had a great look.
You got to have those easy ones. You're not going to get many of them.
Great play called. Rochester kind of cleared it out, and Ruff took it to the basket and just missed it.
They got to ramp up the defense now.
Schultz. Left side to Zahner. Zahner. Over the top of the defense to Schultz. Three on the way. Top of the key for the tie. He's off the mark. No good. Zahner the rebound.
Got to have those rebounds.
Down in the lane. Kicks it out to Llewellyn. She'll fire it for three in the tie. It's good. 36-36, 6:10 to play in the game.
Llewellyn with her third three-pointer since halftime.
Rochester will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the game. We're tied at 36. Last time we were tied was 6-6, way back in the first.
Yeah, I believe it. Well, Michaela Harding with 19 points for the Lady Cavaliers tonight, but Llewellyn with her third three-pointer has tied it up here with 6 minutes to go in the fourth.
We knew that Hardy and Zahner and Schultz were going to be the fourth. We thought the X factor would probably be Llewellyn, and she has been that to this point.
Yeah, she's outscored the Lady Zebras in this second half.
Rochester 5 points in the second half. Holland, top of the key, man-to-man defense. Holland, Drake Rooks goes to the block, fakes the pass, throws up a layup, no good. Hardy with a rebound.
That's about the third layup now, Rochester. Yep, plays. He was missed here in the second half.
Zahner with the basketball outside for Culver. Zahner picks up the dribble, now gives him the right corner to Howard. Her pass is tipped away and stolen, but Rochester going to commit a foul in the reach-in. I think Abbott's going to pick up the foul. It'll be out of bounds to Culver with 5:47 to play in the game.
So Abbott picks up her third, team third.
Now Stasiak and Abbott with three fouls. Llewellyn baseline right, looks triggered in. Does so to Zahner. Top to Howard. Back out
for Hardy.
To Hardy. Hardy loses the handle out of bounds, and that was going to be because she sealed Bailey Abbott.
Yep.
She had the drop step. She just wouldn't watch it into her hand.
Sealed her off, got the pass from out front, and was just drop stepping back for an easy layup when she lost it. Lost the handle on it.
5:41 to play in the game. We're tied at 36. Rochester basketball going to our right. Culver has not led in this game. Holland top of the key against Llewellyn. Left side to Malco. Becky drives in the paint. Stops. Kicks it outside to Ruff. Ruff fakes. She drives. Kicks it out to Malco. Three. Left baseline. Good as it rattles home. 39-36. Rochester back up by three with 3:15 to play in the game. Over the top of the defense to Hardy. Hardy looking for Zahner. Got a nice defense by Malco. Hardy back outside to Schultz. Schultz resets for the Cavaliers. Now directs traffic high on the right side. Drives right in the corner to Howard. She'll fire a three from the baseline. It's short. Rebound to Ruff. Morgan runs. Gets ahead to Holland. Rochester by three. Under five to play in the game. Holland high on the right side. Now top to Ruff. Morgan. No look pass. She got away with a tip out of bounds by Zahner, and it's going to stay with Rochester.
Trying to throw it across court to Larkin, and she threw it right to Zahner. I don't think Zahner even realized it was coming directly at her. She tipped it out of bounds.
Yeah. So Coach Stasiak quickly back to the bench and brings in Bailey Abbott. 4:50 to play in the game. Rochester up 39-36. It'll be Rochester basketball going to our right. Holland directs traffic, top of the key, steps back along. Three is off the mark, no good, but Larkin picks up the long rebound. Allie picks up the dribble, now back to Holland. Boy, she had a great look.
She did. She was wide open. Maybe Holland, a little far out.
Into paint, and Llewellyn, I believe, is going to pick up the foul, which is going to send Holland and the Lady Zebras to the line for the rest of the game.
Llewellyn going to get a little hand check on the hip. And like you said, Holland for the one and the bonus.
4:34 to play in the game.
Holland with 10 points in the first half, scoreless so far here in the second.
Holland's first freebie on the way, good. Rochester up by four. X looking to push it back to five. Biggest lead of the game has been 12. X, second one on the way, good again. 41-36, Rochester with 4.5 to play in the game. Tatum Schultz gives to Llewellyn, and Llewellyn walks it across the timeline where Holland will pick her up. I see a triangle in two. And now Culver will use a timeout. It will be a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Seconds to play in the game. Rochester up by five at 41-36, and right before the timeout, we saw a triangle in two.
Yeah, Rochester trying to mix up the defense a little bit, trying to take Hardy out of the equation. They haven't found a successful way to do that yet tonight.
And now they're back into a 2-1-2 maybe?
Of course, you have to respect, as Larkin knocks that pass out of bounds,
yep.
You have to respect Llewellyn now too, because you know, she's got 9 points here since halftime.
What a better situation Llewellyn has than having teammates like Schultz and Hardy.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Just let me stand out here and shoot a three, and she's done a fine job at that tonight.
Yep.
Llewellyn has the pass knocked out of bounds by Bailey Abbott.
Nice job by Abbott.
4:08 to play in the game. Rochester up 41-36.
If you can't stop Hardy, just stop the ball from getting to her.
Yeah. At halftime, the Valley guys lead Argus 25-23. Rochester in his zone deep. No, what?
Yeah. Larkin's is man-to-man on.
I think it's triangle and two still.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Malco's chasing Zahner, and Holland's chasing Llewellyn. In the corner is Zahner over the top of the defense to Schultz. Schultz, dump pass down a little Hardy. Hardy's jumper over the defense is no good. Gets a little rebound. The putback is good. So active.
Yeah.
I hope 44 on the Rochester bench is watching this. So active.
Well, the thing is, you know, even if she misses, she's right there to get her own rebound. Nobody's getting removed out of the paint.
Rochester now will pull it out and run some clock. 3.5 to play in the game. Rochester up 41-38. Larkin over the top of the defense, right side to Malco. Malco holds against the defense. Around to Schultz. Now to Larkin. Now to Holland. X. Cross over the defense to Malco in the right wing.
Coach Stasiak really hoping he can steal this away from the free throw line.
Yep.
Boy, I don't know. The Lady Cavaliers are really, really good at collapsing in on those passing lanes.
3:08 to play in the game. Rochester content to take the air out of the basketball, and Malco throws it out of bounds.
Yep.
Turnover Rochester with 41-38. Lady Zebras up.
And that's what they do. They had double team on Malco out front. She tried to go over the top. Llewellyn was in the passing lane. Larkin wasn't able to make a move on the basketball, and it goes out of bounds.
2-2-1 zone defense. Schultz over the top to Zahner. Zahner in the corner to Stallier, and then Malco knocks the pass out of bounds right in front of the Culver bench. It'll be Culver basketball right in front of their own bench going to our left at 2:50 to play in the game. Rochester up by three.
Don't lose track of where Hardy's at.
No doubt. Llewellyn. Couple of dribbles, top of the key. Sends right side to Hardy. Keep her out there. Now top to Sallier.
Well, and the thing is, Zahner's so active down low as well. That
Zahner loses the handle. Zahner's going to lose it out of bounds. A lot of contact, no foul. Rochester going to get it back with 2:37 to play in the game. Rochester by three. Culver fans not happy about that no call.
He was probably lucky on that situation that they weren't the ones that knocked it out of bounds.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
Regardless of whether it was a foul.
Okay, we didn't get fouled, but we didn't touch it last either.
Yeah.
Here comes the zone defense, the trap defense by Culver. Malco has her pass tipped away and stolen by Stallier. And then Stallier gives to Zahner. Make that to Llewellyn. Llewellyn on the block. Throws up a shot. It is no good. Rebound to Schultz. Knocked out of bounds by Rochester. It's going to stay with Culver baseline right.
I don't know whether Macko thought the ball went out of bounds or what, but she just quit.
Stop.
The play. Yep. Yeah.
Rochester takes a 30-second timeout, or make that a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the game. Rochester up 41-38. After Rochester's timeout, it'll be Culver basketball out of bounds baseline right.
Michaela Hardy and Llewellyn have accounted for 30 of the 38 points for the Lady Cavaliers.
I think that we would have been okay coming into this game knowing that Hardy would have led them and had a big game. But I think, like we just, like I just said before, Llewellyn has been the X factor this game because Rochester's done a great job on Schultz and Zahner.
Yeah. Well, you know, Harding had 13 at half. She's got 8 here in the second half. So we'd have been okay with that 8. But Llewellyn's 9, her 3 three-pointers.
And that 3 is short. Hardy with the rebound. Steps back to Tatum Schultz for 3, and the tie is short. And Stasiak knocks the basketball out of bounds.
Well, the Lady Zebras need a rebound. I mean, the Cavaliers aren't shooting a high percentage, and the Lady Zebras just need to get a rebound.
Schultz will look to trigger it in, baseline right. Tatum looking. Gets it over the top of the defense to Llewellyn. Llewellyn almost has her pocket pick, gives to Schultz, to Hardy. Hardy, turnaround jumper off the glass, no good. Rebound, fall for Rochester and Culver going to be tied up, and the Cavaliers, nope, Culver's going to get a timeout.
Yep,
Zahner has possession. It'll be a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. A minute 59 to play in regulation. Rochester leading 41-38. And for about the third or fourth time, it'll be Culver basketball out of bounds baseline right. Rochester can't grab a rebound.
No. Hardy and Zahner doing a great job for the Lady Cavaliers. You know, the Lady Cavaliers, you know, they're not hitting a high percentage of shots. You know, they're missing. But the thing is, they're getting a second and third opportunity to put it back in.
Rochester cannot lose track of Hardy. She gets the inbounds pass to Llewellyn high on the right side. A minute 50 to play in the game. Zahner skies to the pass, grabs it behind the arc in the right wing. Donna dribbles out of trouble. Over the top to Tatum, Schultz in the minute 45. Back to Zahner in the paint. Zahner travels.
Oh, travel,
going to go back to Rochester.
And I think, you know, Llewellyn, Hardy, and Zahner are the three that you've really got to keep track of defensively. The Lady Zebras, though, offensively, they've got to find somebody that can knock down a shot.
Malco against the double team, cross court to Holland with a minute 36. Back to Holland from Larkin. In the corner to Stasiak. Keaton bounce pass to Holland. Back to Stasiak in the left corner, minute 25 to play in the game. Stasiak bounce pass to Malco, and Coach Stasiak will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. A minute 25 to play in the game. Rochester leads 41-38. Both Culver and Rochester has two timeouts left. Larkin gets it in to Malco from the far sideline.
Malco playing for an opportunity to go to the free throw line.
That's right. Tatum Schultz gets away with a foul in the corner to Stasiak. Keaton around Donna Zahner. We're going to have a foul on Zahner. Keaton's going to go to the line to shoot one and the bonus.
Zahner picks up her fourth.
Well, here's the most important part of that play was the foul before the turnover because Keaton bounced it off her leg and it was going out of bounds.
Yeah.
So Zahner just picked up foul number four, and Stasiak will go to the line to shoot two, make that one in the bonus for Rochester. Keaton ready. Eyes the first one. It is short, no good, and Hardy with the rebound. Llewellyn outside right at the free throw line. Gives to Tatum Schultz with a minute five to play. Schultz throws up a prayer. No good. Hardy weak side rebound short. Rebound fought for. Stasiak comes out of the whip. She is fouled by Zahner. She's done.
That's a big play by Stasiak. Not only did she get the rebound and stop Culver's attempts at making that easy layup, but Zahner picks up the foul. And that's
so coming back into the game is Howard, and Donna Zahner fouls out with five fouls. How many points?
Two. Finish with five.
Five. So Keaton Stasiak, an opportunity to do it again here. 1-1. 61 seconds to play in the game. We're Rochester up 41-38. Keaton's first one of the way. Too hard.
You know, the Lady Zebras hit a free throw. This margin gets a little wider.
Stasiak then steals the inbound the pass, but then can't stop from going over across. Yeah, over and back. So turnover Rochester, turnover Culver. The Cavaliers are going to get it back, and the Lady Cavs will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Rochester Basketball, 92.1 WROI. .8 to play in the game. Rochester still clinging to that three-point lead. Culver has one timeout left. Rochester has two. It'll be Culver basketball going to our left, and they'll trigger it in right at the timeline. Now, Zahner's done. And Llewellyn and Hardy has been the big scorers, but you don't want to forget about Tatum Schultz either.
Right. Schultz just got 1 point in this ball game, a free throw, but yeah. Zebras just need to get a rebound.
Llewellyn crosses the timeline with 50. Llewellyn outside left with 49. Dribbles around a pick. Loses the handle. Picks it up high on the right side with 45. Now he gives it to Tatum Schultz. Rochester by three with 42 to play in the game. And then Tatum Schultz travels.
Well, I was going to say the Lady Cavs are going to get themselves in a situation where they'll have to shoot a three. I mean, I don't necessarily think they have to right now. There's enough time, but
41.4 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by three. And now you got five ball handlers on the floor because Ruff just came in for Bailey Abbott.
Ball handlers and free throw shooters.
Malco is fouled by Salyer, and Becky will go to the line to shoot two. Yes? No? One in the bonus still?
Well,
yeah. Nope, it will be two.
Yeah, it is the double bonus.
Bailey Abbott will come back in after the first free throw. Becky Malco at the line to shoot two with 34.8 to play in the game. Rochester by three. Malco's free throw on the way is no good. She'll have one more. Rochester's missed, what, four in a row now?
They've missed three. It's their last three. The front end of 2 1-and-1s, and now the front end of a bonus.
Rochester needs this one to push it to a two-possession game. Second one by the junior is good again, good this time. 42-38. Culver will use their final timeout of the game with 34.8 to play in the game. Rochester by four. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 34.8 to play in the game. Rochester up 42-38. After Culver's final timeout, they'll have the basketball underneath Rochester's basket. They'll need to go the length of the floor to our left.
Yeah, and 34 seconds left. I still don't believe that they necessarily need a three-pointer.
No, I agree.
You know, there's
you've got to be looking at 32, don't you?
Get it to Hardy, get the easy 2 points, come down, foul. Rochester's 3 of 6 here in this fourth quarter from the free throw line. Take your chances.
Rochester will put a little pressure on the basketball. Keaton Stasiak will guard Tatum Schultz. Hex will guard Llewellyn. Howard looks to get it in. Howard does so to Llewellyn. Llewellyn brings it up the floor. Ahead to Schultz. 30 seconds. Down low to Hardy. She turns it over, but right back to Salyer. Down low to Hardy. Layup is good. 42-40. 20 seconds to play, and Howard picks up a foul, and next is going to go to the line to shoot two with 22.6 to play in the game.
These are big free throws.
Boy, Rochester had a turnover, and I don't know. Larkin couldn't secure it, and right into the hands of Salyer, who gave it back to Hardy, for a wide-open look.
Yeah.
So Alexa Holland at the line for two for Rochester. Lady Zebras by two. X, one dribble. Fires the first one. It is no good. She'll have one more. 22.6 to play in the game. Rochester by two. Looking to push this lead back to three. Rochester has two timeouts left. Culver with nothing. X, second on the way for Rochester. Good this time. Rochester will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the game. Rochester has one timeout left. Culver is out. Rochester up 43-40. It'll be Culver basketball going the length of the floor. And Rochester is going to put on some pressure.
Yep, and now I think you look for the tie if you're Culver.
Culver's out of timeout. One of their better players.
Donna Zahner
has fouled out. Rochester to full court press. Schultz gets it inbounds.
Don't
Schultz
foul.
Almost carries the basketball. No call. Then turns it over. Becky Malco has it. Dribbles away from traffic with 16. Malco gives to Holland with 14. Culver trying to foul. And then we're going to have an intentional foul on Hardy. Hardy tackled X. And so Rochester's going to shoot two timeouts or two free throws and get the basketball with 12.7 to play in the game.
Wow.
That's a big call with just seconds to play in this basketball game.
Because now they'll have to foul again in order to get the ball back.
X has four. First one is good. No, it's
just two.
Just two and the ball. Yeah,
the
my
ball.
Fault. Yep. Holland with one more looking to push this lead back to five with 12.7 to play in the game. Second one by the junior is good again. 45-40. Rochester on top. They'll have the basketball at midcourt with 12 seconds to play in the game.
All they got to do is inbounds it.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. We have seen a dandy here tonight. We expected nothing less.
You're right, yep. The Lady Cavaliers played a tremendous basketball game.
Malco will look to get it in around Schultz. Malco bounce pass into Larkin with 12. Larkin is then fouled immediately by Howard, and Allie Larkin will go to the line to shoot two with 11 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up by five.
Larkin with 10 points in the ball game.
Good for her.
Yep.
That's a nice way to answer a 17-pointer.
Yeah, I agree.
Allie with two. First one for the junior. Yep. 46-40. Rochester with a 12-point halftime leading. Culver did everything to climb back into this one late. And the second one, no good. Hardy with a rebound with 10. Gives to Schultz with 8. Schultz crossed the timeline with 6. 3 on the way, top of the key with 4. It is good. Rochester does not have to inbound the ball with 1. And then Rochester holds on to win, 46-43. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
I've been buying vehicles at Shepherd Chevrolet for over 16 years. They've always had the vehicle I wanted at a price that I could afford. I trust Shepherd's sales staff to give me the best price and the best financing available. From my work trucks to my personal vehicle, Shepherd's is the only choice for me. Stop out to Shepherd Chevrolet today to get your next vehicle. They really are my local hometown Chevy dealer.
After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save.